is Briggs v. Elliott from Clarendon County. This is a case that planted the seed. When I say planted the seed, they originally did not file for desegregation. When their case for equalization of educational opportunity went before the district court, Judge Waring questioned that objective and said that he could only rule in that case for separate but equal, which is what we already had. So if you wanted a case with me, you better come back with something else. That's when Thurgood Marshall got the idea to go with the desegregation case being challenged through the constitutionality of it. Now, the NAACP is not going to tell you this today, but a great number of them felt that Marshall was moving too fast and the time wasn't ready. And he caught a lot of heat. Now, as time goes by and the success is there, nobody's going to let that touch them. The next case, and I'm not giving them to you in sequence, but the Brown case from Topeka, Kansas. This is coming from a state that did not have a state law demanding segregation of schools. They had an option to search to towns over a certain population that if they wanted to, they could have separate elementary schools for black children. So that in your larger towns, most likely there was segregation at the elementary level. In the rural areas, there was no segregation. The Virginia case was classic as South Carolina, a state that rigidly demanded the separation of races. The Washington case was very different. The 14th Amendment, the constitutional amendment under which this case was initially filed, does not cover the city of Washington, D.C. or the District of Columbia. Its citizens are not covered at all by the 14th Amendment. So that case was then introduced as a legal ploy, and they challenged the constitutionality under the Fifth Amendment for Washington, D.C. In the last case, which is the case from Delaware, and there were really two cases from Delaware, Belton versus Gephardt and Beulah versus Gephardt. That was in the state courts. And the state courts ruled against the state. And incidentally, at that time, there was only one high school in the entire state of Delaware for black kids. Now, the difference in the two cases that were filed, the Beulah case was an elementary child demanding to go to the white school, which was closer or nearer to her. In the Belton case, she had a heart problem, could not walk any distance. And it took her, I think, four or five transfers on the bus in order to get to high school. And then she had about a four-block walk after she got off the bus. So that's why her case was filed, to go to the white school. When the state Supreme Court ruled against the state opted to challenge their own court's decision at the Supreme Court level. And that case was then combined with the other four cases and heard by the Supreme Court. And when I say heard by the Supreme Court, each was argued separately, but there was a joint ruling, and the joint ruling came out under the name of Brown.